Make sure my microphone's on. That's the last thing. Last time I did this. Another thing. Oh, my friend actually, Cole Fox, is saying, hey, if you take the, go down the rear window, or actually, Cole, I got it. I got good access right here, so I'm gonna be using this. And by the way, my friend, who's the owner of this vehicle, Brian, you got a lot of, his name's Brian, and he's probably watching right now. Brian, there's a lot, I have a couple friends that love these type of cars too as well, as the enthusiasts, a lot of them have here too. I like to do live videos. I've never done one on a live classic car. Again, this is my friend's car. I told him this vehicle is not like a typical, you know, modern vehicle or like a Honda, where it's very thin. This is very opposite, thick. Half the time these vehicles have been painted more than, you know, obviously more than a couple times. And in most cases there are some filler in there, but I did go around earlier, just live on Dent Trainer, and I went around and I used a paint gauge meter. I wanted to see what the heck I was running into. I wanted to know if this was gonna be actual, you know, something that I'm gonna be running into a problem. So I did a paint reading thing here, and let me just switch the camera for you guys. You can get a little bit of a different look here. See if I can get that in there. So it's a 10.3 there. 6.8, if you see that, it's probably not that good. It's actually, for a vehicle this, it's pretty good. There's not a lot of bondo there. Actually, there's none that I can see, that I can tell. So this is gonna be an interesting repair. We're gonna do it live. Of course, I'm gonna be using some heat. I've got a little stand here. As some of you know, I don't like to put suction cups on vehicles any longer. Matter of fact, I'm taking those suction cups away from them, unless they have to use it. This is the system that we're gonna go with. So I have a lot of freedom with this system. I don't have to be, you know, I don't have to rely just on the suction cup, the suction cup and the lock line. I can easily just move this around and have some freedom. As you can see, I have a strong arm from Get a Grip, which gives me another more freedom too, to use the heat gun at the same time, using that pull system. Again, nothing on the vehicle, as you see. I did modify my stand too as well. I got something from, Guitar Center. And it's just a little thing that hooked up to the mic stand. And I said, heck, that'll be pretty cool, because I always end up putting my hammers and stuff on the ground, and now I'm not doing that no more. So it definitely helps with that. There's also this toolbox here that I recently started. It's called my toolbox build. I have it on Dent Trainer. I talk about the ins and outs. I'm continuously still modifying it. You can break it down. It's called this T-Stacks. You've got the new tool holders from Carbontech, Endeavor, and it works absolutely fantastic. So they stay in there nice and tight, and you're not gonna get that rattling movement. Now, do I use this if I'm going out on a job, carry it like this? No, I take the tools off. I'm only gonna put on what I need, and this seems to work out like just freaking fantastic. I can just close that. And so I got a lot of little drawer systems in here. I got everything I need there. So if you guys hear me in one channel or one side of the mic, that's because I didn't get the right cord for my microphone. So I'll fix that in post as well once I get used to that or get that. See. All right, so on with the repair. First of all, I'm gonna start some heat on this sucker. that up there. Get that a little closer. I like constant heat on my vehicles because, especially on this, getting this thing set up just right is crucial. I'm gonna move that in there just a bit more. There we go. I'm also gonna grab something just to weight down the stand. I carry also sandbags just around, just in case, just to hold the, just make sure nothing's gonna fall over when I have this much stuff hanging over it. Another wide look of this. So this trunk, it reminds me of Goodfellas, man. You remember the guy who in the trunk, and he was, well, like, he basically got stabbed to death, and but you could probably fit three bodies in here. This thing's freaking huge. So I've got this, I think it's 1 inch or 5/8. I'm not quite sure on how thick this is, but this is kind of a like a 45 degree angle, and it works. It's gonna give me that nice push. I'm using an Ultra, the red cap, the newer version. It's gonna give me a lot bigger pushes. I'm gonna kind of bring the metal from the bottom, bring it up to the top, and come down from the top down into the center. And hopefully we get this out nice and clean. It's getting nice and warm. I want it really warm. Just a little bit more higher. I'm not looking at your comments right now. I'll take a look here. Let's see here. I just bought a beat up van. I'm trying to do a PDR repair on it. First time trying the PDR tool. Good luck, man. It is very, very tough, but check out Dent Trainer if you get serious about it. Goes with that 18 gauge steel. Yeah, me too. So what's up, Steven? G'day, mate. Hey, all right. Here we go. Base clear coat and single stage paint. Probably on this, it's kind of a, I'm not sure if they kept it like that because this is an original paint. It's probably not single stage, I would imagine. Maybe Brian can jump on here. He might have a YouTube account. Hopefully you can. Brian's the owner. He has some sick rides too as well. He has another low rider. He's got Cole Fox. Cole, if you're watching, you and Brian are a lot alike, man. And Lee. Okay, so I'm gonna switch this angle for you. Now, on the post-production, I won't have to go back and forth on this, so. But, you got a nice little view here. One thing about my videos, I just wanna let you guys know, actually I'm gonna do picture in picture here, why not? I'll just do that so you guys can see. That I make sure that you guys see the very good angles. I put a lot of time into my videos and making sure that you guys see. And then also, people who want to use my services, they know I'm super passionate about this. Okay. I'm going to start a little bit down here. I'm going to start working that metal up here and see. I'm going to be very, very careful. Feel hot. That's good. That's nice and hot. Sorry if I'm not talking to the whole thing. I gotta concentrate a little bit here. And make sure I'm not bending no bar. See, Brian, if you're watching, you see that, see how much this goes into? I'm not just gonna pop it out here. I might have to switch to a 90. This 45 is not giving me the best angle. But then if I go 45, hold on, I might think I got a dent craft tool here. Oh yeah. Hold up. Guy's like, Jane, what's he doing, man? I'm coming back. I'm gonna use this one. This big bad boy right here. That's some real metal right there. The 45 is not giving me the direct push. It's kind of slipping off there a little bit, so that might not be long enough, but we're gonna see. I meant the extension. No, it is. Okay, this is better. This is better. Had to do this live, didn't you, Mike? Had to do it live. Okay, right here, if in case you're wondering. Brian had to give me, you know, I don't see this guy for a few years. We went to Vegas together the last time I saw him. Hey, Mike, I got this easy dent for you. Just kidding, John. So it is coming, okay? You can see it's starting to work out a little bit. Now, dent trainer guys who watch this and then they watch dent trainer again with this on there, I'll be zooming in, showing a little bit more detail. Sometimes I stop the video, I do a little bit more explanation. I'm not gonna do too much explanation here because that's what dent trainer is really for. Kind of just showcasing this a little bit. Lots of heat on this car, lots and lots of heat. I am going to tap down just a little bit. That also reassures that I'm not going to, overstretch the paint. Let's see here. What I do like to use is a tip like this. And a little good hold paddle here. And let's... that one's good too. R4. I'm gonna go with this one though, just for now. Because this is I need just a little bit more broader tap down. So, do it on here. It might not look like it did much, but trust me, it does. And another reason why I like using rubber tips on something like this, that's been painted, is it's not going to leave marks. So I don't want to have to sand anything I don't need to. Okay, I think we're in business right here. And one thing about a good PDR tech, don't get too anxious. You know, a good PDR tech stays patient. Even though you see it, you're like, okay, I just want to do one good push here, and then I'm gonna just get it out quick. That's how you make mistakes. That's how you can shock the paint and really cause more work too at the end. Thank you. So far, so good. I got to make sure that this tape is not, or not tape, this tip isn't busting through either. Even though this is a really long-lasting tip. Yeah, it's kind of breaking through. I think it's because it's so hot inside there. So let me... Thing is with this is that, do I have any pliers here? Let's see if I got my pliers. Yeah, good. So I have to take this cap off here. And it's one of these caps that you can't get it off, which is a good thing, but a bad thing as well. So that's why I use these. I'm gonna go get another tip. I'm still building my toolbox. I'm trying to figure out what I need. And if I have to walk to my toolbox and get something that's common, like caps, then obviously I need to put it in that little to-go mobile setup. Plugs. All right, so these caps are really hard to put on too. Oh man, I'll get on the ground here. There we go. So now you see, I have a nice new tip. And the reason why I knew is because it was making not normal pushing. It was pushing just a little differently. And I was like, that's not usual. So I pulled it out and it was starting to tear in there, which is probably caused from the heat that I'm using. That's why I like these thicker caps. Oh, it's coming. It's coming along. This is the part of saying stay patient. And I don't do many videos all the time. I'm not one of those guys that just do video after video. When I do a video, I like to do a good video. Not saying that no one's doing good videos. I'm not saying that, but it's kind of like my podcast. So if you follow my podcast, for the most part, I'm consistent every 2 weeks, but well, this weekend I took some time off. But anyway, so it's coming, okay. But going back to this video, if you like the content, please subscribe. That way you get notified when I do videos like this. You won't miss out. It's always far more interesting to watch me do live videos. I'm more of a live guy, spontaneous. And if you follow me on my Instagram or Facebook, I do live videos at least every other day. And they're very interesting. I would say you'd probably enjoy that just as much as you'd enjoy watching this. It's coming. I'm about ready, almost ready to switch my tip because there's just a little bit of low in there. So far, so good, Brian. He's the owner, in case you guys are watching. You can come pick it up tomorrow morning, bro. Come get it. After I do a photo shoot on it, though, of course. It's coming along really good. So I'm going to top down. I got to still be careful. Now, the thing is, I want to get like, there's a little micro pinches in there. There's still micro lows in there. I know it's kind of hard to see. I'll pull the board back. There you can see it's a little bit still fat in that section right there. So I'm gonna go with an R4 now to tap down, because R4 is gonna give me a little bit more precise. Let's see. I might even push with one of these too, because I'm using such a big cap. It's got a little bit of a crown down here that you probably can't see, but see, when the metal gets hit, it goes somewhere. It's either a little bit here, a little bit up there. Anytime you have a near body line. Yeah, I think I'm gonna switch tips, like pushing wise. Tell you what I'm gonna do. I'll explain what I'm doing on Dent Trainer, ladies and gentlemen, right now. I am just going to although I am going to use a little bit of tape. Gaffer's tape is my friend. If you guys just want to know why I would use gaffer's tape, it's just to prevent me from slipping. I'm getting that nice push. I'm using a plastic tip. I don't want it to slip. And then I have to fix a high spot. So that's what I'm doing right there. See, there you go. I didn't slip though on the tool itself. I slipped on the bar. Now I'm getting way more precise. I'm not pushing the shoulders up anymore. I'm pushing exactly where I want to push the low at. Again, in post-production, when I finalize this edit and put it on Dent Trainer, you'll see a lot more detail because I'll zoom in. I got three cameras going on right now. So I'll flip back and forth to that. Plus some B-roll on the other video. But now I'm almost got it. I gotta move my board a little bit more. Still got a little bit of a low up there. This is the hard part. I tell my customers, I'm gonna spend 90% of my time on the last 10%. That's the hard part. Almost got it. This is the hard part. It's so long, the car is so long that it's hard to see the angles that I need to. Sorry if I'm breathing hard too. And this heat helps tremendous too, because it softens the metal up as well, along with the paint. Sometimes watching this process, this last 10%, almost like watching a flower girl. But that's when someone's learning PDR, this is the most frustrating part. because it makes you doubt like what you're doing. Are you pushing in the right spot? Are you seeing it right? Are you moving your board? Still see, I can see it perfect from here, but when I'm trying to move it, when I'm trying to use my tool, I don't get the angle, I don't have the leverage. For the most part, it's coming out really good. It's just that last little bit, of course. Well, Brian, I can leave it like this and it'll look like the rest of your car, dude. So nobody will know. I'm just kidding. Okay, yeah, just. Now you can see it looks like a little bit of texture inside there. I can move the camera in a little bit. Well, you guys can get a better look. It's not too much better, but there you go. Look at that. So I zoomed in for you guys. Now, unfortunately, it won't let me keep it like this. But you can see that just that little bit. It might stay like that. We'll see. No, it won't. Let me do it again. See if I can get that. And you definitely, here's another rule. Don't go too big too long and don't go too sharp too soon. It can get you in trouble both ways. That's the importance of reading reflection well. Look at that, consistently it's starting to look clean. Finalizing the last little bits. Let's see here. Oh, I know what tip I gotta use. Check this out. This is a cool little tip right here. This is ultras. It's kind of like if you guys been in the PDR game for a long time, you had these tips called, they're from Anson. I think they still sell them. And they had these sleeves like this that you see. Looks just like it. And dude, they worked really good. And Ultra makes these little sleeves. Matter of fact, I'm gonna replace this little sleeve. Because again, I don't wanna make any marks. Okay. So this'll give me a very accurate tap down without poking in into the paint. Shoot, I'm sorry. How's that? Ooh, it's hot. You see the kind of tutorials that the information, these are the type of videos that we do on Dent Trainer a lot. So if you guys are like that, you're serious about learning, or you're curious what kind of videos are on Dent Trainer, they're like this. Not all of them though, but a lot of them are very, very good like this. Let's see here. A little something up top. For me, moving the board is critical. I'm not moving it as much as I should because I'm still letting you guys see the majority of the repair. But if you weren't here, I'd be moving this board twice as much. Because I'm constantly looking for the most obvious. Because the most obvious becomes less obvious, and the less obvious becomes the more obvious. I don't know if that makes sense. Ooh, it's got a little pit inside. And that's, whew, turn that off now. It's got just a tiny bit more up there. I don't know how much of this I'm gonna be doing and showing, but I can tell you right now that this repair is coming out really well. I'm gonna use probably a smaller tip. I'm gonna push a little bit more. I'm not gonna cut you guys and say goodbye already. But here's some tools I don't even use that often. Okay, these aren't my everyday tools because you can't get half these tools, you can't get most of these tools down anything except maybe a big wide open bed, quarter panel, something like that. Even then, I'm not really using this tool. This is actually a hail bar from Dent Craft. Still a very, very good tool. It's just heavy. I mean, this, and that's what you want. You want some heft behind your pushes on something like this because it makes it feel a lot more easier. And then you've got your ultra 45 degree angle. And this is also a somewhat of a hail bar / quarter panel. So this is why I keep tools around. If I had my traditional 3/8 tools or even a half inch tool, I would have too much flex in this quarter panel and I'd be fighting the flex and I wouldn't get the drive that I need right on this repair right here. So let me go. Actually, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take a chance. I'm gonna take my tape off. Unless I see, you know what? I got something. Go to my handy dandy. This bad boy right there. Now this is match grade tooltip. And this is really gonna get into that fine, small stuff that we're looking for. You can see it's got a little bit of texture in there, little micro lows. That's what I'm chasing. So I'll turn this heat on again. Now the skill here is don't slip. Don't slip. I definitely don't want to slip. Now, you know, before I start, I'm gonna let this warm up just real quick again, but I'm gonna go up back to the comments here and see if anybody has any questions here. I'm still working, dude. I see Matt. What's going on, Matt? Using your arm too, dude. Let's see here. A lot of heat. Woo. Mark Simmons from Oceanside. What's up, Mark? Nice. That's like right there. Matt's from Oceanside too. It takes balls. You're right, dude. Could you have lifted the glue pole? No, not at all, dude. Not on this one. Not on this. You don't want a glue pole on this because, first of all, it's definitely been repainted. And the one stage paint, even if it wasn't repainted, you would be pulling that paint. You might not pull it the first time, but you will pull it eventually. And we don't want to do that. And the dent's just too deep in that area. Is this metal on the older classic cars harder to push or today's newer? Absolutely. 100% right. Okay, cool. Thanks, John. Don't forget to take your time. Yep. You heard me say that already. Base clear or single stage, and we already went over that. So, okay, cool. Dude, Dent Evo. Dent Evo's in the house. It hid your comment, dude, because you said the word ass. So I just want to give you a heads up. But I undid that. I made sure that you were seen on that. Dan Evo, check him out. He's in the San Bernardino Riverside slash up north a little bit, northeast, inland area. So go check him out. Dave-O, what's cracking, dude? How you been, man? Adam Senior, how are you doing? Whose car? How long have you been doing this? Adam, this is, I'm not sure if you're asking me how long I've been doing PDR or how long I've just been starting on this car. So I'll answer both there for you. So I've been doing PDR for almost 30 years. Well, it'll be 30 years. Is it 30 years now? No, 30 years next year. So in the summer of 2001. How long I've been working on this vehicle? I don't know, what, about 35 minutes, something like that. And so anyways, all right, let's push. All right, let's see if I can get this last tiny bit out. Now, in some cases, I am gonna have to over push it, but we'll see. This tip is pretty sharp. And I'm not using a metal tip because that's just too dangerous right now. I'm good, but I'm not that good yet. Still working on my another 30 years and I should be good. I should be able to take dents out with needles. Okay. Yeah, this is definitely night and day. So you see it, I call it, when I'm training my students, I call it the baton. I call it the relay, okay? You gotta have relays with your tools. Pass the baton, man. If you don't pass the baton, you dropped it. And what happens if you drop? You lose the race. And it's not a speed race. It's just making sure you get to the finish line, period. Matter of fact, you know, customers, usually the longer you take on a repair, the more value they think they're getting, which is, I can understandable. But it's also a bonus when you're experienced and you're fast. So yeah, it's fitting. It's fitting in there nice and clean. I'm not slipping. I got the right amount of length on here. I was definitely contemplating doing this live or not. I was like, man, if I crack paint or if it's bondoed and it pops the bondo, my friend Brian's gonna, he's gonna come down here, like, he'll be down here. He lives in Fallbrook, probably about 45 minutes away. He'd be down here in 10 minutes, dude. He'd probably be here live. Ooh, hot. Look at that, it's coming. I still got a tiny, gosh dang, I freaking hate cameras. I hate cameras. Got a little bit of a low here. Yeah, a little low there, and a little bit there. Where's my drill? Drill a big fat hole right underneath the wheel well, dude. I don't think I wouldn't either. Yep, I said it on camera. You know, I'm holding a special, the month of December, free holes. I usually charge $25 for them, but this month, come on over, dude. Get your dent out and a free access point. You know I'm kidding, right? So you guys, don't take that to heart. Some of you guys probably think I'm serious. You know, my stepdad, when he was doing these repairs for customers, this is obviously in the early 90s, customers would go, what are you doing? Is that a heat? Is that, and it was, he wasn't using a heat gun, he was using a light, right? But it was this big old light, which I'm gonna show in a little bit. Is that a solar panel? Is that putting heat on the panel? You know, and this is without, turn that off. This is without, you know, using regular heat. He had his big light up, his light like this. And the customer's like, wow, what is that? Is that like a solar panel? Is that heat? And my stepdad would say it with a straight face to the customer and go, yeah, don't touch it for 1 hour. The customer's like, oh man, all right. Because nobody heard about paintless dent repair then. You could ask 100 people, nobody would understand what the hell paintless dent repair was. They had no clue. They kept thinking, so when do you paint it? And we're like, we don't paint it. We take out dents without having to paint. They just couldn't grasp it. And like, it was normal for them to do that. Now today, maybe 2 out of 10 people know what PDR is. Maybe 3, but it's still not as high, as popular as you would assume. Do your own survey, like ask random people, hey, have you heard of paintless dent repair? And most of them are gonna say no, they don't even know what it is. So we almost got this thing. I'm still twerking. I don't think I need any heat anymore on this. Look at that. You see that little freaking heat cameras, man. Hey, stupid cameras. You can see I got a little bit of a micro low. Yeah, right there. I told you, this is the hard part. You know what? Not gonna do it, dude. not gonna do it. The reason why I'm saying that is because I've been in that situation where I didn't use heat the last 5%. Ah, that's good enough. Pop, and the paint cooled down. You gotta understand, paint like on these type of vehicles, or any deeper paint, when you stop putting heat on it, it cools down. It's almost like reacts like ice. So it loses its flexibility and the paint pops when you get this close. Now from my angle, I'm chasing something else, but from your camera angle, you're probably going, man, Mike, a little bit to the more to the right. Oh, almost got it, a little bit left. Just push right, man. If I saw that, I'd be pushing on. I know, ladies and gentlemen. It's easier to be a keyboard warrior back there than to actually be doing it. Hey, how many of you would be in my shoes and push this live with everybody watching? Yeah, that's what I thought. I read minds, by the way. I've been known to do that. Okay. Almost got it. Ouch. Almost got it. I'm sure Brian's texting me by now. I haven't looked at the text. Match grade tips, you can, if you PDR guys are watching, you wonder, you know, where you get these tips at, you can get them at, I'm not going to put any links right now. This is a live video. I'm going to go home after this, go see my kids, and I'm working late tonight, obviously, but I'll do it sometime when I do my dent trainer links. I'll just put that up too. Ouch. Okay. So if you are in need of paintless dent repair, you're in the San Diego area, contact me, 858-943-9676. Let's put that pride back in your ride. We work on all types of vehicles, all types of vehicles. And it don't matter if it's a daily or an exotic or a classic like you see here, we're gonna make sure we take good care of you. We're gonna work on it like it's our vehicle. Woohoo! It's coming along. The boy's good. You know, I'm actually am getting pretty good at this. I told you, I got another 30 years and I'll be, I'm down to earth, guys, you know. Come see me, stop by. If you're a PDR tech, And you're in the area? Man, I ain't like those other dent guys, like all, well, I didn't say, you know what, that's bad, I shouldn't say that. I'm not like some dent guys who are very insecure, don't want to meet with you. Man, come on by, man. Say hi. Now, I'm not here all the time at my shop. If you're wondering what that clicking is, because there's some sound deadening or that spray-on stuff inside there, and I'm just kind of slipping off of it. That is looking pretty steezy. I've got a little micro cleanup there. Damn cameras. I got a little bit of, let me just push that. See, I can't help it. I can't help it. I forgot what I was saying. Oh yeah, so come on by. I'm friends with most of the dent guys here locally anyway, so. Matter of fact, one came by, I sold a lot of my tools to him, like my old ones I didn't need. So you might pick up something if you come by. Okay, gosh, every time, I need a magnifying glass now, man, because I'm getting old. Man, good thing about all, look at all these great tools, man. Makes life a lot easier. Okay. I'm gonna dabble with that off camera a little bit. That looks pretty dang good. Actually, let's zoom in. Yeah, you see that? I just got a little bit of squiggle. Little bit of squiggle. That's pretty dang good. Okay. I'll do a little bit of top in here and there. Not too much more. But yeah, I'm pretty pleased with that. So really good actually. So that concludes my repair on this 66 Impala. I want to say thanks a lot, Brian, for bringing your ride over here, dude. I know you trust me a lot, and I appreciate that, man. So yeah, come by tomorrow. Hit me up after this. We'll talk after that. And everybody, I hope you guys had a great Thanksgiving. We'll see you guys on the next live video. And heck, like I said, get on denttrainer.com if you're interested, if you want to dabble in it. And if you're a PDR tech and you're interested in tool discounts at the same time, if you're a member, you get a lot of different tool discounts from a lot of major PDR companies. My name is Mike Toledo. Again, if you need my services, 858-943-9676. And you can follow me on Instagram at Dent Time, Dent Trainer, and all the other Facebook and handles and all that crap. So talk to you guys later. See ya. Oh, before I go, I'm gonna read some more comments just before. I don't wanna be rude. Okay, let's see here. Congrats, and yes, I meant PDR. Thanks for answering. Cool, yeah, you're welcome, man. Can you also show it with a fog and fade? No worries if it's too much. Oh, all right, dude. You know what? I'm glad I read the comments, man. You know what? Glad you asked. We're gonna, absolutely. Absolutely. Dave wants, let me do this. I'll move this out of the way. I just happen to have the Carl Stuckey light here. Let's see, I'll turn that on. I'll turn them both, all of them on. Let's see what we got here. Okay, let's see it getting in there. Raise that up a little bit too. There you go. Probably, see, there's the lines right there. You can see the little, so you guys can see I got a little bit of texture in there. And like I said, I got a little micro top downs. Not much. And something like right here, you see how you can see the high spots here. Let me just move out of that way here. See, it's harder to even see. See this little, those are just little highs I gotta tap down. Now, I would personally tap down, if this was normal paint, I'd be using this and it'd be all good in the hood. But I gotta be very, very careful and go back and tap with this. And because this is a little bit too big, it's probably gonna put a little micro low in there, but I get the high down. That's why it's gonna take even more time, because I'll probably make little mistakes. I don't wanna sand into this. I don't know what this is what this is gonna do if I sand it. Okay, I don't know if it's gonna go through. I don't know how thin the base coat is on here. So I'm not going to sand it at all. I'm just gonna leave. If there's some micro imperfections, that's just gonna be good enough. But it will be about another 5% better than this, at least, minimum. But again, you're not going to, you know, that's why we use these lights. Of course, I don't have the other natural reflection on it though, but you can see that. And then there, see, there's the lines. And then there's your fog, okay? So I hope that helps, Dave. Let's see here, what else there? Brazil, what's up? Minecraft Novo. Alan Chen, press and repair. Thanks, Alan, appreciate that. You're welcome. Great job, thank you. Thank you very much. So, okay, so we are, now I'm finally gonna be out of here, okay? So you dent training members, you'll be able to see kind of like a little bit more in depth on this, and then we'll show you the access there as well. We'll take a look, we'll go around the vehicle, show you what exactly that vehicle looks like from top to bottom, and all that good stuff. So, all right, finally, I'm out of here. That last call, that's it. See you.